What's up, guys? Today on 3 minutes to better bushcraft gear, a Russian axe. So a while back, I bought an axe off of eBay. It was a Russian axe. So this is a Soviet military axe. And the thing is an absolute beast. It has over a 3 pound head, short handle. It just cuts really, really well, holds an edge really long. And I mean, it's just good steel. You can tell when you're sharpening it, it is very good steel. So I was using that for a while. And then I watched a documentary called Happy People. And they were using the same axe to make canoes. They were also using a smaller style of that axe for just everyday living, from making skis to making traps to having it out on the trap line. And I went online and lo and behold, I found one. Now this axe has been like the holy grail to me. There's just something about the weight, the balance of it, everything, the sharpness. I mean, it carves like a champ, it splits and chops like a champ. It just, I love it overall. So like any crazy bushcraft person, I'm gonna talk it up. I'm gonna say how much I absolutely love this axe. It's like my holy grail. With that though, comes people asking where I can get that axe. And I honestly didn't have an answer for the longest time. And then people over time kept asking and asking and asking, and then it switched into telling me that this place had them for sale, Coleman's Military Surplus, at $29.99. So I had to go online and check them out. I got two. So this is the actual axe that Coleman's Military Surplus sells. Now, as you can tell, it looks a little bit different than the axes that I had, not just because of the pretty paint job. Handle is a lot longer. It's a 28 inch handle. The head is about 2.5 pounds in weight. Right out of the box though, I can tell a few key differences. Number one, the bit is just way thinner. So the profile of that is way thinner than all of my other axes. Not by much, but a good amount. The other thing is that the metal just didn't feel the same. It just didn't feel like good, hardy, robust metal. Now, it didn't feel like cheap Chinese steel, but it didn't feel like the metal on this axe or this axe. But I still gave it a shot. I made sure that the head was seated very well on the handle. I sharpened it up, started using it. I just was not a big fan of it. Between the metal not being too good, as you can see right here, the handle just did not fit the eye of the axe all that well. It just, there was a lot of downfalls to it. One upside though I can say to it is that I like the handle. I like this profile handle. I like the shape of this handle. I like the length of this handle. Everything about the handle I really, really like. So even at $29.99, I just don't think it's a worthwhile investment. So this only gets a half a thumb up. That's it. It's not getting anything else. I just don't think that it is just, the quality's not there. The versatility's not there. It's just, it's not it. Although it looks cool, it's not there. Don't even waste your time. But if you want to click the link, it is below. This was Dan Wowak with Coalcracker Bushcraft and 3 minutes to better bushcraft gear. Stay in the woods.